Geeked Week.
Welcome to day two of Netflix Geeked Week 2022.
Today is film day. I'm Jaeden Martell. I was recently in the movie Metal Lords, and you may have also seen me in Knives Out and It.
I have seen you in both. And I'm Reece. I'm that one guy who makes videos about working on TV shows and movies.
I've seen you in those.
Thank you.
We've got a big day ahead of us, full of surprises, reveals, and even a dash of magic.
Ooh. We'll get some sneak peeks, hear from some of our favorite actors and directors, plus share tons of first looks at some exciting new movies coming to Netflix.
Like Day Shift, the vampire action movie with Jamie Foxx.
I'm very excited for that one. Plus, Wendell and Wild, the new stop-motion movie from Henry Selick and Jordan Peele.
That's an all-star combo right there.
Exactly. We're going to get a nice deep dive on two upcoming movies. The first is the action-packed The Gray Man.
And the School for Good and Evil. We'll be sitting down with their cast and creators later today. Cannot wait. But first, it's time for some reveals.
Let's jump right in the deep end with The Sea Beast.
Calling all kaiju fans and Loch Ness Monster conspiracy theorists, are you ready to get geeked? I'm Carl Urban, and I've got a Geeked Week sneak peek at the trailer of our new movie, The Sea Beast. I voice Jacob Holland, a great legendary sea monster hunter who braves unknown waters on an epic journey to find creatures so ferocious it'll make history. Where the map ends, our adventure begins. Don't miss The Sea Beast on Netflix, July 8th. It's kind of hard to miss. These sea beasts are pretty freaking huge.
There was a time when sea beasts would ravage our shores, and no ship was safe on the sea. But those days are over. Today, valiant warriors battle the beasts far beyond the horizon. Jacob Holland, a weapon against nature's darkest design. And I'm joining your crew.
Oh, no, you ain't.
Hey, put me down, let me go!
We'll be off to kill a monster!
Ow!
You stowed away?
Yeah.
I like this kid. We're dropping you off at the nearest port. Hunting ship ain't no place for a kid.
But you joined the ship when you were me age.
Hold on, Daisy!
And look at you now.
That's not the same thing.
Isn't it?
No, it isn't. The Drakemore's thick with monsters. Monsters that want to eat us. We're not keeping it.
But he's so cute.
You and I have a different idea of cute. Just don't move. This be going.
I see a fire in her. Same fire I saw in you.
The monsters I can handle. We got it right where we want it.
Wait, Jacob!
That one. She'll be the death of me. I swore I would do everything in my power to keep people safe.
You can be a hero and still be wrong.
The ocean has sent us its worst, then we'll send it right back.
Wanted a pet.
That's not a pet.
But I already named it.
Let me guess. Blue.
Aww.
From Chris Williams, the director of Big Hero 6 and Moana, comes the epic animated adventure Sea Beast. Badass main character turns soft by the end of it.
No, I love that. And I feel like Carl Urban's like the perfect person to do that.
Perfect.
Because the guy looks so menacing, but he's so charming.
So charming.
Yeah.
Perfect voice.
Yes, absolutely perfect voice.
In addition to Carl Urban, the Sea Beast has an all-star cast including Zaris Angel Hatar and Jared Harris.
Also, Marianne Jean-Baptiste, Dan Stevens, and Kathy Burke. We have a never-before-seen poster from the film.
Nice.
Yeah, no, I love it.
Fortunately, you won't have to wait long to hit the high seas with The Sea Beast. It drops on Netflix July 8th.
That's so soon.
Yeah. Our next film is an exciting new project from acclaimed Norwegian director Roar Utok.
Let's check out an exclusive first look at Troll.
Hjorta vi Orostein.
Med snøent hjerte. Is til vei.
Så mørket kan du. Lyset den.
Troll comes to us from Norway, where we get to encounter a gigantic creature come to life and follow his misadventures as he heads towards Oslo. I feel like the trailer looked scarier than that synopsis.
Did not seem like the plot twist at the end is that he's good. It appears he is up to no good. Roar Utzog previously directed Tomb Raider, so I can't wait to see the awesome action sequences we're sure to get in Troll.
I have no idea what to expect.
Neither do I, but I'm excited. And also, it's nice that we're getting a nice international feature.
Yeah.
Because they have such a different take on action, and it's so much fun to watch.
Very true. Check out Netflix Film and Netflix Geeked on Twitter for all the latest updates on this very exciting project.
This next film has everything. Comedy, action, Jamie Foxx, and a supernatural creature we haven't covered yet. Vampires.
Wow, we're really getting into all the mythical creatures.
I was going to say, like, we have a kraken, we have a troll. I don't know if it's a rock troll or a regular troll in vampires.
Jamie Foxx,
also mythical. Do you have a favorite between, I guess, vampires or werewolves?
I like myself a vampire story.
Okay.
They're a little sexier than trolls.
They
and
are.
Sea beasts.
Yes. You know?
We are talking about Day Shift, a new R-rated film from the team behind John Wick. Oh, sick.
Yes.
They know there's going to be some action in this.
Director J.J. Perry, who was a stunt coordinator on everything from John Wick to F9, is reuniting with producer Chad Stahelski. He's the director of John Wick, and together they're making a vampire movie unlike anything I think we've ever seen.
Yeah. To give us a taste of what's in store, here's a first look at some of the action and stunt work in Day Shift coming to Netflix this summer.
Yo, what up? It's Jamie Foxx. You are not prepared for Day Shift. This is gonna be like something you've never seen before. This movie has what I call eating popcorn moments. You know, when you're like, oh, shit. Oh, ooh! In this movie, I'm in the business of chasing down vampires and getting money for fangs.
Good energy, guys, here it comes.
Good friend of mine, J.J. Perry, we started as stuntmen together way back in the late 90s. Having done all the John Wick films and then reading the script, I think J.J. makes Day Shift a fresh take.
I love the idea of the vampires because it takes us up a notch.
Oh, no! No! Oh.
J.J.'s taken some vampire mythology and put it in crazy situations of gunfights and car chases and motorcycle chases.
We're making something that you've never seen before. It's fun. And the stunts that you see is amazing. And it's practical. The way JJ uses all of his stunt women and men is brilliant. So I cannot wait for people to get a dose of this and find out how to kill vampires right here on Day Shift.
That looks like so much fun.
That looks like a lot of fun. Right off the bat, what's your biggest takeaway from that?
The contortionist. That freaked me out.
In addition to Jamie Foxx, Day Shift also stars Dave Franco and Snoop Dogg.
That is crazy. That is so fun.
Did you ever think you'd see Snoop Dogg hunting vampires in your life?
I didn't. And I didn't know that I needed that.
Yeah.
I do need it. Up next, we're talking about a spine-tingling mystery coming from Spain.
Ooh.
España.
Exciting. Are you a fan of the mystery? Well, you've been in a mystery.
I am a mystery.
You are a mystery. He's an enigma.
No, really not.
This new slasher is called El Club de los Lectores Criminales. It's got fans really hyped.
And we have a special intro from the cast. Check it out.
Bienvenidos al Club de los Lectores Criminales.
Sí, este es un club un poco diferente al resto.
Se podría decir que a veces leemos libros.
Pero no es lo único que hacemos.
También cometemos crímenes.
Huimos de la justicia.
nos traicionamos entre nosotros.
Y nos culpamos mutuamente. Y aunque no lo sepas, ya estás dentro de este club.
Oh, fucking crazy. Sorry.
Are we allowed to curse?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Oh, fucking yeah, Netflix. Too far.
But yeah, no, that looks really cool. And I like that they don't really give anything away. They just kind of set that spooky mood.
Setting the tone here.
Yeah. They should have given us flashlights for this.
Missed opportunity, guys.
Yeah. But in this new movie, a creepy clown starts murdering the members of a college book club one by one. But they might not be as innocent as they seem.
Sounds fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, who hasn't had a creepy clown chase you and your friends?
Yeah, no, exactly.
Been there?
I was gonna say, that was, you know, last Tuesday for us. Be sure to check out L Club on Twitter at Netflix Geeked.
3, 2, 1, blast off.
Close enough. We'll be checking out the new sci-fi comedy Blasted, which comes to us from Norway and is actually inspired by a true-life UFO event.
Ooh.
Yeah. Are you a big alien guy?
Big alien guy. Do we believe in aliens?
Yes, to an extent. I don't believe in, like, those little green guys. No, like, I think there's, like, a planet of maybe, like, bacteria. What about you?
Bacteria, yeah, absolutely. Definitely bacteria out there. Mm-hmm. But that's not exciting. So let's get blasted.
Yeah.
We've got an exclusive trailer for Blasted right here for you at Geeked Week.
Are you ready for this?
I'm
ready. Det veldig, veldig intenst.
Jeg elsker intenst. Noen karer der inne som sier at de det beste lasertag-teamet I dette bryllupet?
Nei, det kan vi ikke ha noe av.
Sean Bean?
Hugh Jackman?
Audun? Det må bli det beste utrykningslaget noensinne.
Vi skal feste med en fyr, helt til han kjøper et abonnement.
Jeg tror Kasper har det gøy. Det går fint, vi må bare finne på noe gøy.
Paintball? Paintball. Vi skal spille paintball.
Jeg tror jeg skjøt noen.
Er han dab, eller? Han puster jo.
Det full av en romlig
Paintball på gullelapp paintball?
Nei. Hva det? Det var jo, var det?
Det husker vi jo med.
Om det akkurat det som skjedde.
Hører dere seg selv om dere fisker?
Å kjenne på at vi sitter I en politibil og skal skyte aliens med laserpistoler. Bilbelte på!
Ok, laserpistolene dreper aliens.
Blasted follows a career-obsessed workaholic, Sebastian, and a laser tag prodigy, Mikkel, two childhood best friends who are reunited for Sebastian's bachelor party.
But when the bachelor party stumbles headfirst into an alien invasion, it's up to Mikkel and Sebastian to reunite as the kick-ass laser tag duo they once were and fight back.
So this movie's like Hangover meets Hot Fuzz with UFOs in Norway.
You should be writing the synopses.
That's
pretty good.
That's good. Good one.
Genuinely, I'm sold.
Elsa Pataky is a certified action queen, and her new movie, Interceptor, just hit Netflix this past weekend.
In the film, Elsa plays a military expert in a race against time to save the station she commands.
Sounds like some good action.
I would love myself to one day be a certified action queen. it doesn't look like it's in the cards just yet, but who knows?
The action sequences are fantastic in Interceptor, and Elsa is here to give us a behind-the-scenes sneak peek at how they brought these epic stunts to life. Elsa, take it away.
I'm Elsa Pataky, and I can't wait to share with you my new movie, Interceptor. In Interceptor, I play this amazing role called G.J. Collins. It's a very strong, independent, fierce woman that has to beat everybody up. And I really enjoy doing it. We actually train really hard over 6 months. fit training, gym, weights, getting strong with an amazing team of stunt people and stunt coordinator. We get like almost like over 800 moves, like seriously, your fights. Stay tuned as we take you behind the scenes.
How you prepare for an intense role like this? Well, I always dream to do an action movie because I love to challenge myself. And when I read it, I was like, I mean, it was everything you want an action movie.
Interceptor is a big action movie, but the whole story takes place in this high-tech room.
We knew very early on that the film would live and die on the quality of its fights. That all depends on the actor, how much she can be taught, how much she can learn, how much she can process, and how much she can deliver it. Fortunately, our actor is Elsa Pataky.
Elsa Pataky is awesomeness personified. She got into physical shape for the movie, and we're talking Linda Hamilton, Terminator 2, fit. She did months of fight preparation.
She was with us every single day, and she would just keep asking for more.
Jade is just relentless. She never gives up. Never gives up.
Ain't nobody like me, but everybody like me. Pretty girl swag, and my wrist stay icy.
There's six major fight scenes with highly trained assassins, and Elsa is single-handedly kicking every single one of their asses. There's 800 beats of fight choreography to learn. One thing that's very different in this film from other action films is that it's a female lead. If you looked at the characters that she's fighting side by side, you would say she's well and truly outmatched. But we move very differently to men. Men carry a lot of weight in their upper body and in their shoulders, and we carry it in our hips. So she's quick, she's agile, she gets around and in between, and she uses everything at her disposal to gain the upper hand. She uses the environment in a creative way in every single fight scene. I had the best stunt team.
So much fun. It's like, give me more. I can take it. Got a couple dudes in the back, yeah, they waiting for me. Got a couple
ladies that don't want to take them from me. We are setting up to shoot The Leap of Faith, in which Elsa swings one-handed and jumps a 2.3-meter gap under SBX1.
Yeah.
It was hard work, but I enjoy every second of it.
By the end of this movie, I had put her through so much, all these fights, hanging from one arm, putting her underneath the billowing clouds of a rocket launcher.
You can't ask for any more in a leading lady. Everybody, Elsa Pataky.
She was so dedicated and so passionate about how she wanted JJ to be portrayed, you know, a strong female character that kicks major ass.
Badass.
She was smiling through most of that.
Yeah, what a beast.
Interceptor also stars Luke Bracey and features a cameo from executive producer and Elsa's husband in real life, Chris Hemsworth. And I really just love to see him in things.
We may be seeing Chris later in the show. From aliens to action stars to infected flesh-eating monsters?
Hide your brains, folks. Our next title is actually a brand new announcement. Let's check out this next film from Japan, which is inspired by a hit horror manga series.
Hello, Geeked Week. ゾン100企業での激務で、その夢も希望もない毎日を送っていたアキラが、ゾンビの出現によって、持ち前のその超ポジティブシンキングを発揮して、底抜けに明るくサバイバルしていくっていう物語です。ゾン100原作者の麻生ハロです。作画の高田です。
映画作品とか、まあ、ゾンビ映画ももちろん大好きなんで、純粋にもう映画ファンとして映像として自分の作品のゾンビが動いているのとかはもうただただ楽しみですね。自分たちが作ったものが、他の人が関わることによって違うものになる。ちょっとやっぱ面白い感じになってくれればいいかなみたいなのがあるんで、映画ファンとして楽しみにしてます。
まあ、ゾンビ映画だからすごいパニックものなのかなと思いきや、そのすごい前向きなポジティブな話だったので、新しい目線のゾンビ映画だなっていうふうに思いました。
コメディとして書いてたんで、そのゾンビあるあるはとりあえず入れていこうと、入れれるだけ従来のゾンビものとして描いて、そこでアキラが従来のゾンビ映画に出てくるキャラクターとは違うことをするっていうところを見せたかったんで、やりたいことをやれる、できる人がたくさんいた世の中の方が楽しいなと思って、なんかそういう人たちの背中を押したいなと思って、だからアキラみたいにみんなが寄り添えるようなキャラクターって考えてました。
アキラはですね、本当にポジティブな男ですし、何事にもまっすぐで全力で、とてもキラキラしているキャラクターかなって思います。すごい楽しいです、日々。
とにかくあの撮影を横から見せてもらって、あの演者さんたちも楽しそうにやってるし、非常にポップで明るい感じでできてると思いますんで、なんかその辺をみんなでワイワイ楽しんでいただければいいかなと思います。
漫画の段階では日本人ターゲットで始めてたんで、面白く買ってもらえたらいいんですけど、そこも興味ありますね、海外の人がどう感じてくれるのか。
世界中 の、 そのゾンビファンの皆さんにも楽しんでもらえると思います。で、またその笑って明るい気持ちになれるので、ゾンビが苦手っていう方も見ていただきたいです。僕が演じるアキラがどう前向きにサバイバルしていくか、ぜひお楽しみください。ゾンビ映画なのに笑える爽快感のある作品です。では、
Zombie 100, Bucket List of the Dead is about Akira, a young man whose dull life is invigorated when a zombie apocalypse hits his town.
Yeah, we're very excited to also be sharing a first look at Zombie 100, Bucket List of the Dead. Let's see it.
Honestly, this looks very fun. I like how well lit it is. I feel like a lot of times zombie movies will try to go into night and like up that scare tactic. But this looks fun. He's on a bicycle. He could be enjoying himself.
No.
Probably not.
The original manga series was penned by Haru Aso and illustrated by Kotaro Takata. Hmm.
And here is our Zom 100 star, A.G. Akaso, who's playing Akira.
Very exciting news that this beloved manga is coming to Netflix. Coming up, Juju Straw Hat Goofy is sitting down with the Russo brothers to reveal an exclusive clip from the new action movie, The Gray Man.
And later, Tessa Netting catches up with the stars of the new Paul Feig movie, The School for Good and Evil. Today's Geek Week programming is literally just getting started. Geek Week.
Next up, we're taking a look at Wendell and Wild.
Now, this film comes from the delightfully wicked minds of Henry Selick and Jordan Peele.
From The Nightmare Before Christmas to Coraline, Henry Selick has created some of the most iconic stop-motion animated movies of all time.
Yeah, no, for sure. And did he traumatize you as a child?
Well, of course.
Combining that with the hilarious duo Keegan-Michael Key and Jordan Peele in the starring roles, this is truly, like genuinely, one of my most anticipated movies of the year.
We've got director Henry Selick here with a sneak peek from Wendell and Wild.
It's Geeked Week! Geeked Week. Don't forget your eyeballs. Wendell and Wild will be there. Get geeked!
Bring it out! Bring it out!
Above.
Wendell and Wild is a tale about two demon brothers, Wendell and Wild. They enlist the aid of 13-year-old Kat Elliott, who's a tough teen with a load of guilt, and she's voiced by Lyric Ross, and she summons them to the land of the living.
But what Kat demands in return leads to a brilliantly bizarre, comedic adventure like no other, an animated fantasy that defies the law of life and death, all told through the handmade artistry of stop motion. Attention to detail is like mind-blowing.
I was gonna say, that's really cool. Like, I love how like she peers around the corner and her hair moves a little bit. Like, I can't imagine like how painstakingly tough it is to make a stop motion. Also, had you ever seen Henry Selick before? Like, his face?
Yeah, never.
He seems like a nice guy,
yeah.
Which is very surprising from the stuff he makes.
I'm excited to see what Key and Peele, how they fit into this universe.
Wendell and Wild also features the voice talents of Angela Bassett, Ving Rhames, and James Hong.
What a cast.
No, it's genuinely hard to believe it's been 13 years since Henry Selick's last movie, Coraline, was released.
That's wild.
No, isn't it? Like, it genuinely, like, 13
that's
years
That's Wendell
old.
And Wild, some would say.
That's pretty good.
With that. Our next title is Spiderhead, starring Chris Hemsworth.
The best way I can describe Spiderhead is like Maniac meets Squid Game with just a dash of Black Mirror.
And I like that.
Yeah,
I like
no,
the sound
so
of
I
that.
Feel like we're gonna get some like cool sci-fi elements and it might get dark.
Let's check it out.
Yeah.
Hello again.
Sorry I'm late, Mr. Amnesty.
Not late at all. That's Spiderhead. We're proud of our work.
Your presence in this facility, while technically a punishment, is a privilege.
Where have you been?
Drug study.
In science, we have to explore the unknown.
They've been testing me up and down. A lot weirder stuff than usual.
This is new frontier stuff here.
Before we begin, I need your permission to administer Dan 40.
This place can really mess with your head.
Drip on.
Acknowledge.
Drip on.
Acknowledge.
Acknowledge.
Yeah, acknowledge.
Let's do this. Where are we getting this?
Whoa. This doesn't feel right.
Time to worry about crossing lines was a lot of lines ago. Our work will save lives. Not just one life, many lives. We're making the world a better place. What you want is redemption. And this is how you're gonna find it.
We're selling peace and harmony itself.
Beautiful people get away with too much, and I say that having benefited myself from time to time.
Hello, everyone. Chris Hemsworth here. Apologies I couldn't be there in person. Hope you're doing well. I'm very excited to show you an exclusive look at my new film, Spiderhead. It is a futuristic thriller set in a state-of-the-art penitentiary where inmates have an opportunity to have reduced sentences by volunteering for experiments involving mood-altering and mind-altering drugs. And this is all under the guise that it's for the betterment and benefit of mankind. But as you can imagine, it's not quite the case. Check it out. It's unique and exciting. Hope you enjoy.
Sorry, I'm late, Mr. Amnesty.
I'm going to retire the day you call me Steve. Not late at all.
Heather, on the other hand, is the devil.
Sorry.
All right. Oh, how rude of me. Jeff, Heather, Heather, Jeff. For the record, either prior to or during your incarceration here at Spiderhead, have you two ever spoken?
No.
No.
Ever interacted in any way?
Did I not just say no?
No.
So what do you think?
Who are you asking?
I'm asking both of you. Let's start with Jeff.
Yeah, she seems nice.
You like that word, but no, I mean, how attractive is she?
What, Steve? You can't see for yourself?
Heather, can you shut up, please? I'm asking Jeff. Jeff, how's she looking?
Come on,
man. Scale of 1 to 10.
Yeah, she's a 7.5.
And Heather?
He's all right. A 5 on a good day.
Did you give her honesties?
No, I would have to ask. You know that?
I'm just kind of a bitch.
Oh. Well, then I'd like to change my vote to an 8.
All right, Jeff, Heather, can I have your permission to administer N40? Drip on?
Acknowledge.
Yeah.
Heather?
God, she's a pain in the ass.
Acknowledge.
Thank you. Come on, guys. Words, words, words.
Okay, yeah, she's starting to look pretty good. Yeah, she's looking really, really good.
Heather?
Same. Yeah.
Pump up the verbalist. Let's get him talking.
Oh, God, she's so beautiful.
Yeah, don't tell us. Tell each other.
Oh my God.
You're stunning. You're gorgeous. I'm so sorry. I don't know why I didn't see it before.
It's okay. You're the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in my life.
Thank you.
Wow. Yeah. I could.
Yeah?
I could.
Good what, Jeff?
You weren't lying with the Black Mirror, the Maniac, the Squid Game.
No, like I hadn't really known much about it going in, but that looks really cool. It
looks very cool. I don't know where they're gonna go with this. And is Chris Hemsworth a good guy? Is he a bad guy? I don't know.
I'd kind of like to see him be the bad guy.
Yeah.
Because I feel like he always plays like the good charming type. Mm-hmm. And it'd be kind of cool to see like that dark, like what are...
Bad charming type.
Yeah, like this little app thing. What are the ulterior motives?
Mm-hmm.
Joining him in this stack cast are Miles Teller and Journey Smollett.
And well, you know, the soundtrack is beautiful.
Yeah, the Doobie Brothers, mm-hmm. Wonderful touch. Whoever decided to put that in there, good job. Spiderhead is coming to Netflix on June 17th. Oh, that's really soon. Be sure to follow Netflix Film and Netflix Geeked on TikTok for all the updates.
And that's it for today's Geeked programming.
Whoa, wait a minute. Hold on, we're not done just yet.
No,
we couldn't let this year's Geeked Week pass without an update from this special guest.
Hey, Geeked Week, I'm Zack Snyder.
And I'm Sophia Butella.
We're on the set of our big new movie, Rebel Moon. It's a giant space opera with visual effects.
Sci-fi fantasy.
Crazy action, right?
Yeah, about a bunch of misfits that come together against all odds.
So you've been training hard.
Yeah, for months now, and we just started shooting.
And it's so far awesome.
We have an amazing cast, exciting costumes and makeup and characters that you won't believe you're looking at.
Yeah, some aliens and all sorts of craziness. And really proud of the team that I have working there. Doing an incredible job. So really, for me, it's a dream come true. So thank you, Geek Geek. Oh, wait, before I go, keep your eyes peeled. There's gonna be a bunch of stuff we're gonna be dropping along the way. Content, maybe some videos, some stuff from on set. So keep your eyes up for that and enjoy.
Thank you, Geek Week.
Thank you, Geek Week.
Well, that's exciting.
I was gonna say, that looks really cool. He also is able to wrangle an amazing cast for like every movie he does somehow, which is like kudos to him.
Right, because he has that appeal.
He does have that appeal. In Rebel Moon, a peaceful colony on the edge of the galaxy finds itself threatened by the armies of the tyrannical regent Belisarius. I don't know what that means, but I'm intrigued.
They dispatch a young woman with a mysterious past to seek out warriors from neighboring planets to help them take a stand.
I like to imagine she goes to each planet, walks into like a bar and is like, I'm assembling a team.
Probably better execution, though.
I think she'd give it with, like, much more oomph, as opposed to my, come on, guys, like, let's go. We're gonna make a team.
Yeah. And one of them's like, no, I'm not doing it. And then you're like,
no, I would immediately give up. Okay. Every moon I protect. Conquered.
Zach would have loved to be here today, but as you can see, he's a little busy. He's a little busy building his epic adventure.
I mean, a little offended. Like, how busy can he actually be?
Billy want to talk shit on Zack Snyder?
But he does at least love us enough to send us a special message from the set of Rebel Moon.
He's also hard at work on a few other Netflix projects, Army of the Dead, Lost Vegas, and Twilight of the Gods. And Netflix Geeked, we'll have more news on those coming soon.
Heck yeah. Okay, was that actually everything?
You wanted more?
Well, technically there is more. Up next is a panel for the Russo Brothers' latest film, The Gray Man, which stars Ryan Gosling, Chris Evans, and Ana de Armas.
Hmm. And a special look for The School for Good and Evil, in a discussion with the cast.
But actually, that's it for us, so make sure to keep watching Geeked Week all week long for even more releases, surprises, and everything geeked.
Peace.
Bye.
Bye.